In this chapter, you will place zones in the rooms and create dimensioned model views, which can be part of the documentation. Archicad incorporates a wide range of design documentation tools and techniques. Some of these tools will be briefly presented in this chapter. Archicad Zone Tool helps to identify 3D spaces and stores multiple attributes and properties associated with them. Rooms and groups of spaces, for instance departments or areas with similar functions, can be easily identified with the help of colored fills zone identifiers or space stamps, which can be assigned with a single click. Archicad's automatic and associative dimensions refer to project-specific locations. This means that you are free to develop and edit all the elements in your design project. The previously created associative dimension chain will always be automatically updated without spending extra time on dimensioning. Archicad's detailed drawing views are extremely helpful at the project documentation stage since they allow you to reuse and further enhance your existing 2D details. These can be stored in various file formats such as DWG, DXF, or DGN, or you can create new details based on the model geometry. You may continue working on the current project, or open the Chapter 3 PLN Archicad Solo Project file to complete this chapter of the training series. Zones represent rooms in the building. They are defined by categories in the Attributes section of the program. Archicad zones are real 3D spaces. You can use them to create conceptual space studies as well as to create detailed space lists and area calculations. You can trim the 3D zone spaces to slabs, roofs, or beams to create more accurate volume calculations. Use the options, Project Preferences, Zones option to fine-tune the zone-related calculations and element subtractions. Zones can gather information from the surrounding building elements, like door and window holes or roof trim. In the Appearing dialog box, you can set how a zone calculates wall openings, columns, and roof trims. Set the values to meet the local standards. Close the dialog. Go to Options, Element Attributes, Zone Categories. Based on the project designation, you can define the necessary categories here. All zones must be part of a category, but the appearance can be customized later zone by zone. Close the dialog. Zones can identify existing geometry such as boundaries, walls, lines, polylines, columns, etc. Later on, you can update zones so they follow the changes of the boundary geometry. Based on how you want to use zones, automatic boundaries can be the reference lines or the outer edges of walls. Later on, you can edit the edges of the zone with polyline editing methods or edit the zone body with solid element operations. If there are no defined boundary lines, or if you use zones before modeling the building itself, for example in the early design phase, you can set the boundary lines manually using the polyline editing methods. Open the zero ground floor in the navigator. Activate the zone tool and open its settings dialog. Set the parameters as follows. Zone category, education and culture. Zone name, exhibition space. Zone top, 1, gallery, home plus 1. Top offset to top linked story, minus 0.24. This is the thickness of the slab. Subfloor thickness, 0.00. Bottom elevation to project 0, 0.00. Geometry method, inner edge. Zone stamp panel. Scale sensitive, off. Representation section. Show measured area, on. Show floor finish, on. Show zone number, on. Show ceiling height, on. Background fill, off. Finishes section. floor finish, parquet. Layer, model unit, zone. Click OK to close the dialog. The zone is set to automatic boundary detection using the inner edge geometry method. This means that the zone boundaries will be found automatically along the inner edges of the elements. Click inside the large room area to detect the boundary. The cursor changes to a hammer. Click again to place the zone stamp. Please note, the point you click is marked with a small blue plus sign. This represents the point around which the zone boundary detection recognizes the zone area. This means that if you draw a new boundary element between the stamp and the plus sign, the zone will be updated based on the plus sign. Repeat to create additional smaller zones. Entrance. Communication and access category. Top offset to top length story, -0.46. This is the thickness of the flat roof slab. Floor type, tiles. WC and washroom. Technical equipment. Please note, zone numbers increase automatically when you place a new zone. You can change the boundary of the automatic zones with polyline editing methods, but they keep the automatic behavior. This means that if you run the design update zones command, these automatic zones will recalculate their area based on the boundary geometry around their plus signs. Now we go to the gallery level to add one more zone. Open the 1 gallery floor plan in the navigator. Open the zone settings dialog. Set the education and culture category and type gallery as name. Set the top offset to top length story to 0. Select the manual geometry method. And set the floor finish to parquet again. Click the corner points of the gallery slab to define the zone area, but do not include the opening. The door area will be added automatically. If necessary, hide the layer of the rafters.